Koko certainly got his work cut out for him here. He's gonna have the support of the crowd 100% behind him.
And his miserable dirty bird.
And look at that other devious individual.
The colonel.
Yeah, right out of nowhere. Now the guy's a colonel. Before he was just the mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. Now he's a colonel.
You spent 14 days at a fruit stand, and you were calling you a gorilla.
Yeah. One of our lovely federettes there at ringside, getting ready to take the jackets and the ring attire.
A little scrawny.
Coco's ready. Frankie's ready.
Oh, natural black hair.
Obviously, Honky is not ready. Got 42 pounds of some kind of cream in there.
I ran my fingers through his hair one day. He told me, go ahead, so you can tell the world. It's dry as a bone.
Oh, yeah.
Just natural shine it has.
Bell's gone. We're underway. I'm sure Coco's thinking about using that tremendous speed. Something's wrong. Honky doesn't want any part of the Birdman right now. He's saying he doesn't have any grease.
Well, see, Coco's trying to tell the referee to check his hair. He's got grease on it. But now he's got a glove on. They're not even checking the glove. Why would he have a glove on?
Obviously, he has an injured right hand.
No, that's so he can hitchhike at night and they can see him.
Please, give me a break. Coco stalking to Honky Tonk, who slips out underneath that top rope. Referee Dave Hebner right there to push him back immediately. Once again, SRO signs went out early here for this World Wrestling Federation matchup. That's standing room only.
I know what that means.
Finally get a lockup in a referee's position. Nice armbar. Comes out of there with a ringer, Honky Tonk does. Well, at least he met him face to face, unlike what he did to Jake the Snake Roberts.
Who was that, Strongbow there?
I don't know what.
Oh, that's from Frankie the Pigeon.
Oh, right over the shoulder of Frankie, or over the beak, so to speak.
Or Bruno.
Yeah, you don't want to hear Bruno. You want to hear Bruno say that to you. He'd do a number on you in a hurry.
I don't think Frankie'd be too happy either to be compared to Bruno.
You'd be wearing a glove. Arm ringer reverse now by Coco. Really going to work on it. The mouth looks a little upset. Right hand didn't break it. Third one doesn't break it either. Ducked around that one. Look out, atomic drop. Nailed him with it. Won't be twisting quite so energetically after this. Slam, beauty.
You know, Coco tried to purposely insult the man by messing up his hair. Did you notice that?
Well, I think that would be a personal insult.
Well, the man cares about his grooming, how he looks. Nothing wrong with that.
I don't know, the mouth looks like he could use a little grooming.
That's the style now.
Rags, is that it? Got the new style, rags? Back inside the squared circle once again and complaining to the referee. We may see a little fisticuffs here. Oh, look at that. Side headlock by Coco. Honk gets rid of in a hurry. Nice leapfrog. Over the top, shoulder block, a beauty.
I'll tell you one thing about Coco B. Ware, it's probably one of the most dangerous finishing holds in professional wrestling.
The Ghostbuster.
He could break a man's neck. He could put a man out permanently. I don't mean out of wrestling, I mean out.
Sort of sealed a casket on your career, so to speak. Understand, you fall into the same category as the colonel and the honky. You're deathly afraid of snakes.
I'm not afraid of snakes. I'm afraid of nothing.
Side headlock now by the Honky Tonk Man. Looking to gain some kind of control in this matchup. Coco doesn't want to stay in this too long. He's coming out. Standing wrist lock, perhaps. He doesn't really have the kind of height you need. No, he didn't get it.
I'm gonna show you someday I'm not afraid of snakes. I'm not afraid of birds either. I think I may pluck that pigeon.
Into the ropes, look out. Got nailed again, stopped dead in his tracks. Oh, nobody home on that one. Coco in trouble, down on the canvas. Honky Tonk, wow, right into the sternum area. Honky Tonk's dangerous when he's got you in a compromising position. pulls out all the stops, and if he can put that shake, rattle, and roll on you, he will.
And Bruno again.
Frankie. Hey, Frankie keeps one eye on everything all the time.
Frankie kind of looks like Duggan when you look at him. And one eye watching you and the other a fly.
Hacksaw Jim Duggan, you want to start making some derogatory statements about him as well?
Well, I don't like him. He's very uncouth.
Koko in deep trouble. Having a few words with some of our ringsiders as well. Best pay attention to what's going on inside.
Didn't Bruno have a
nice
shirt?
Block.
Didn't Bruno have a shirt like that?
Wow, nailed him. Koko exploding now with a couple of right hands and another one. Beautiful uppercut. Look out, in for the ride. Oh, caught one right in the lower abdomen.
Nice ride, Koko.
Gotta be careful just when you look at it. Oh,
please.
That's a waste of time right there, Brain.
I don't know why they don't play his music during the whole match.
Oh,
he could do a little something to you, knock you down, do a little dancing, pick you up, slam you. Do
slam
a little dancing.
By Honky. Look out. Going to the second turnbuckle on the inside. Dedicated that to someone. Oh, nailed him right between the eyes.
Me. He dedicated that to me.
What a nonchalant cover. Forget about it. You're not going to beat Koko that way. Honky, but definitely in control at this particular point in time. Irish whip coming up. Bombs away. No. Ducks under the right hand. High cross body. Down he goes. Referee way out of position.
See, now you know what I've been talking about, the officiating. Just blame Danny Davis.
It's a high-flying action. The referee was all the way over on the other side of the ring. But what a nonchalant.
Quiet, my friend. He's dancing.
Well, not singing, is he?
No, but you don't know. If he breaks in a song, I don't want to miss it.
Oh, please. They hung this guy for being a good singer to hang an innocent man. Handful of hair, drags him up to his feet, rammed him. Oh, look at the danger involved there.
Well, you know, you could break maybe 4 or 5 turnbuckles doing that.
Please. Ramming the back of the head right into that steel top turnbuckle.
Talk to him, Colonel. Talk to him.
Taking the full brunt of the blow right on the external occipital protuberance. Very dangerous.
In the back of the head.
That's what I said.
Yeah, but keep it simple for the humanoids.
Drags him back in with two hands full of hair. Look out. Oh, I thought he was going for it. Nice fireman's carry.
The man can wrestle too. He's got it all.
Showing us he's had some amateur background. Perched again. Nice elbow.
Nice.
Look at this, though. Look at this, Bobby.
Should have hooked the leg.
You're not going to beat Koko Beware or anybody else with that kind of a cover.
But maybe he's just playing with him right now. You know how a cat pulls the feathers off a bird or... Well, you know what I mean.
Chinlock. Applying some pressure onto the neck now.
Quiet, Coco's singing now.
Chad going out greaseball, I believe they're saying, Brain.
They shouldn't say that when Coco's down like that. A man's injured and hurt.
You're talking about the Honky Tonk Man.
Oh, well, then they're wrong.
Youngster's not going to quit in this particular hold. You can bet on that. I believe it's been changed to a chinlock now. Can't tell from our vantage point. Elbow to the lower abdomen and another one, and he's out of there. Nice sunset flip. Can he get him? Oh, his legs are too short to reach his shoulders.
Legs are too short to reach his cuffs.
Honky Tonk got out of there in a hurry. Oh, nice standing clothesline.
Honky Tonk has dominated this match.
Shades of Jake the Snake Roberts.
Believe me, Jake the Snake wants no part of Honky Tonk.
Once again, the very nonchalant cover of the Honky Tonk Man, and a two count is all he can get. And the Colonel is telling him about it, I believe, Wayne.
He talks to him all the time.
With that horrid megaphone. That's one of the big faults I see in the Honky Tonk Man. He's always worried about what people are saying at ringside instead of worried about what his opponent's going to do.
I never concern myself with what the people are saying.
Scared to death.
First of all, you can't understand them. You ever talk to a person with three teeth?
Take a look at some of the capacity crowd here this week once again for this World Wrestling Federation matchup. Main event in any arena, anywhere in the entire wrestling world. Koko coming out of there. Got that adrenaline flowing. Nice block. turns the tables, and it's Honky rammed into the top turnbuckle. Just like that, here the guy had a chance several times to put Koko away. No, didn't do it. Another block. Honky rammed in once again.
I don't think Coco's got enough gas left.
Oh, look at him. Yes, the motor's running. Big right hand. And another one. Koko unloading. Irish whip in.
What's in that glove?
Backdrop.
Oh.
Nailed him with it. Koko going bananas. Frankie loving every minute of it. Now headbutt. Could be the beginning of the end. Turned into a Pier 6 brawl here. Drop kick, a beauty, standing drop kick. And another one. Oh, look at that 360. He went down head first. The mouth trying to get him back on his feet.
How do you think Koko will have it in him?
Koko just exploding.
It's not over yet, though. Honky Tonk's going to pull it out. He's going to pull it out. He's got faith in the guy.
Suplex from the outside. Oh, look at that, Jimmy Hart, holding on to the legs of the Honky Tonk Man. Oh, look at that, scoop the right foot of Koko. Give me a break. What a miscarriage of justice.
What? I was getting a floor cue over here from the lady here. I
wanted to watch the monitor.
Yes, Jimmy Hart did grab the Honky Tonk foot.
Yeah, then he grabbed Koko's foot as well.
I missed that. I can't do it all.
Give me a break.